This video was brought to you by GeneralPack.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Consider subscribing and supporting through Patreon.com/GeneralPack. This is the mechanism for you to support us financially so we can continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Our corporate sponsor for this topic is AllumiaX.com from Seattle, Washington. Contact them for industrial and commercial power system studies. Why we use perunits in power systems, part 2b. In this video, we will demonstrate the advantage of using perunits in power systems and how it makes it easy to calculate and compare different equipment. By expressing the impedance of different electrical equipment in per unit, it is easier to compare their characteristics. Now, it's worth mentioning that we're specifically talking about comparing impedances in per units because the size of electrical machines varies and its internal impedance, voltage drop, and losses also vary. For example, a primary circuit reactance of 0.1 ohms would be much higher for one transformer and on the other hand, much lower for the other transformer. And the driver for this is the voltage, power, and various other ratings of the two transformers. However, if that equipment, whether it be a machine, transformer, generator, capacitor bank, etc., would have its electrical quantities converted into per unit values, the different voltage drop and levels disappear and the impedance can be compared over the same scale. Now, this is a huge advantage of using per units in power systems. Now, let's consider an example from the book of Electrical Power Systems by B.M. Weedy, 5th edition. In example 2.3, it says a DC series machine rated at 200 volts, 100 amps has an armature resistance of 0.1 ohms and a field resistance of 0.15 ohms. The friction and winding loss is 1500 watts. Calculate the efficiency when operating as a generator. Now, let's ignore the friction and windage losses and efficiencies and then focus on calculating the percent losses instead. Now, we will employ two methods to do that. One is by normal calculations and the other is through per units. Now, method one, the normal power system method, is that you calculate the total resistance, which is 0.1 ohms plus 0.15 ohms, which equals a total of 0.25 ohms. And we know that power out is voltage times current. The voltage is 200 volts and the current is 100 amps, which means that we got a total power out of 20,000 watts or 20 kW. Now the P losses we also know is described by a common equation called I squared R. We get 100 amps squared times 0.25 ohms, 2,500 watts. Now the percent losses, we also know this by a common formula called P losses over P output times 100. We know that the P losses was 2500 watts and the P output is 20 kW or 20,000 watts. And we multiply that by 100, which equals 0.125 times 100 or 12.5%. That is the percent losses. Now let's solve the same example by way of per units. And method two, we'll use the per unit method. And we know that to convert the system into per units, we require base values and actual values. In the case of this machine, we will take the ratings of the base value and we will get the base voltage and base current. We will now find the per unit impedance for the machine. So the total resistance again is 0.1 plus 0.15 ohms, which gives us 0.25 ohms. And the per unit impedance we know is simply equal to the actual impedance divided by the base impedance, which then equals the actual impedance divided by base voltage over base current. Well, we know that to be simply equal 0.25 ohms as the actual impedance divided by the base voltage of 200 volts over the base current of 100 amps. And that gives us 0.125 ohms. Now, if we compare the two values between method 1 and method 2, we will find that they are exactly the same value. It's exactly the same results. This means that under the given ratings, the per unit impedance is equal to the percent losses in terms of impedances. Thus, if we employ either of the methods in comparing more than one machine, we can determine which machine is more efficient. And the difference is that by using per unit calculations, we don't have to perform these extra steps and calculate as we did in the first method. And so this is one of the reasons why per unit impedances or per unit calculations is much more desirable in power systems, because they eliminate some of the extra calculation and make the problems more simple. Now this concludes that if we want to compare different different electrical components, we could simply calculate the per unit impedances and find out the desirable component for our power systems. Now, manufacturers usually simplify the impedance of a component in percents or per units on the base of the nameplate rating. Now, in this video, we saw how per unit system can ease the comparison of different electrical equipment and power systems. In the upcoming video, we will be dealing with an example of per unit systems for transformers calculations. Now, we hope that you have a continued interest in this topic and see as a student professional, and we also hope that you find this content useful and enlightening. Please consider subscribing to generalpack.com and becoming our patron on patreon.com/generalpack. Thank you.